Newmarket, New Hampshire has a magnetic quality, drawing people from as far as California to live and work there. Perhaps its small, manageable size part of the attraction?
It could be, but before exploring that idea, let's get some breakfast under our belts.
In her travel blog, Seacoast Lately, Maggie Sutherland describes Newmarket as a smaller, more affordable Portsmouth.
It's like exciting to see new pocket towns pop up and people being able to start new young businesses and thrive here and have another alternative of places to go.
When Sutherland first visited Newmarket, she began at the Big Bean. When owner Jack O'Sullivan and his business partner, Sarah Tebbets, decided to open a restaurant, this is where they wanted to be.
In Newmarket, it was just an up-and-coming town. We loved it here. We lived here during college, so it was just the right fit.
The breakfast-lunch spot is a favorite of hippies, parents, and kids who know the Big Bean has standards.
We don't get up early in the morning to make anything bad, so we try to work on every aspect that we have here.
The bread is homemade, food local and fresh, coming together as familiar dishes with a twist.
There's our hippie, which is a very popular meal. It's been here for a long time. And that is yogurt and granola and fruit, beautiful display of fruit. It's our Wouldn't It Be Nice, which is a falafel and egg burrito. Our Maroni, which is a breakfast quesadilla with chorizo and eggs and salsa and avocado and sour cream. Then there's our Spock, the scramble with peppers, sausage, onion, and hollandaise and cheddar.
One block down the street, Inkwell Flowers. The space is small, but owner Jean Colacci perfectly arranges a variety of flowers, both cultivated and wild.
We go out, we forage in the woods, cut branches and wild things that grow there and mix them all together. It makes for a nice look that's a little less traditional. I like plants. I come from being a gardener. I'm an artist and a gardener, and I like things that harken back to traditional painting where you might see plants in different stages. You might see things that are budding. You might also see things that are dropping a couple petals and stems that are curling. So you've got some different shape and movement going on.
Colacci moved from Berkeley, California to New Hampshire more than a decade ago.
We wanted to live in New England, so we looked around and decided this was the place.
And when she decided to open 2 years ago, Main Street was the obvious choice. The people, scenery, a blend of her West Coast vibe and East Coast blooms.
It's more Berkeley than the other places around here. It's funky, it's arty, it's pretty, and there's all sorts of great stuff here. It's a nice place to hang out.
It seems almost wrong to spend the day in the Great Bay Area without indulging in oysters. So we leave Newmarket and head to Franklin Oyster House in Portsmouth.
Oh, we do oysters really well. We like to focus on New Hampshire Great Bay oysters, cold oysters off the raw bar, as well as different hot preparations.
Chef owner Matt Lewis is a New Hampshire native and four-time James Beard nominee.
I grew up in New Hampshire. I went to the Culinary Institute of America, and then I went and worked in California, New York City. I didn't have intentions on coming back here, and then I realized I liked it. It felt like home. And then I started meeting all the food people in the area and oyster farmers and realized there's just a wealth of product here. This is the Franklin oyster right here.
Right here.
They are the best oyster out of the Great Bay. I find them very well balanced, a good salt, but also a good sweetness.
Here we go. Do we cheers?
Cheers.
That is so fresh and delicious.
So
fresh.
So clean. Yeah.
Pretty dynamite.
And back to Newmarket, a lot of the business owners attribute the revitalization of downtown to the redesign of Main Street.
Yeah, the sidewalks are wider now. The power lines are now underground, making the area more walkable for browsing and just enjoying the area for residents and visitors.
It's amazing what a difference that can make in so many places. Wednesday is pickup day for Great Bay.
Volunteers have collected thousands of shells over the years, and the bay is already seeing improvements.